sir.
Paul.
Come back, goddammit!
Don't.
Stutters were getting bad. He's shifting back and forth without warning. At the time, I didn't think it'd get much worse.
But we both know it did.
Good.
Need to get the hell out of here. Jesus! Cut it a little close, Jack. It's like a goddamn maze in here.
Beth had been on her way to meet me. I expected she was frozen somewhere up there, by the side of the dry dock.
Shoot me.
Look, I'm sorry, but I'm taking the bet.
That's for not listening to me back there.
Ow.
You want to stop time from breaking down? You need my help. And thanks, by the way, for the plus one in the back seat. I'm starting to feel like goddamn babysitter.
She scares me, Jack.
My ride, my music. Deal with it.
with this. We have to shut this...
What led you to the swimming hall?
Will said there was something important in his briefcase. All I found was a key with Bradbury swimming hall on the chain. Only lead we had.
I guess this is it.
This building's been shut down for years.
Perfect place to hide something you don't want found.
I think it's time you tell me what you know.
I know your brother built the one thing that can stop the fracture. I know we're meant to find it, and I know Monarch doesn't want us to.
And yet you're wearing their uniform.
I like the way their pants fit.
Yeah, I bet you like the paycheck, too.
Tried to create a cover to gather information. You've known about this for a few hours. I've been preparing for it for most of my life.
You weren't aware that William owned the place?
There's a lot I didn't know about Will.
We need to find your brother's countermeasure. And fast. Things will get worse as the fracture progresses. And Monarch will be turning Riverport over looking for you.
Will's key. Maybe it unlocks this. Key doesn't fit. Okay. I'm gonna find another way in.
Make it quick. I'll keep a lookout for unwanted company.
This is weird.
Huh. I could swear this is the same cab I was in when I came to the university.
It's a taxi. They all look the same, don't they?
Will had used the building to hide away his personal items.
Okay, May 17th, 1998. This is William Joyce, and I'm about to conduct the first animal test of the machine prototype using my trusty pet mouse, Schrodinger, in order... Wait, he's gone.
We need to keep our contact limited from this point forward. I'll find you in the conjurer's room.
Come to Willie. Come on. You're okay. You're all right.
Come on, Will. What did you want me to find?
Okay, finally, we're sending Schrodinger into the machine clockwise through the corridor.
Hello, Riverport. Teresa Sedmak here, filling in for Bobby Rathbone. About to brighten your day.
Any luck in there?
Working on it.
Let's take a look around. Down here.
Nice work.
This note. It's directed at me.
July 4th, 2010. Beth Wilder, I'm addressing this video to you. You told me to stay away from my workshop. But I couldn't just leave it there. I went back to get it. And the entire place is a disaster zone. The countermeasure, gone, taken. Oh, shit.
What the?
Safe, empty. I just need to know you have it. Because if it falls into the wrong hands, its power is immeasurable. Our future. future. Our entire lives depend on it. This can't all be for nothing. You know where to find me. Please, hurry.
2010. Holy shit.
What was that?
He recorded that for me in 2010?
Beth Wilder, what the fuck? I'm addressing this video to you.
You said the countermeasure's gone?
But I couldn't just leave it there.
It's not good.
I went back to get it.
We need to figure this out.
It's a disaster zone.
Let's keep looking.
The countermeasure, gone, taken. Oh, shit. Safe, empty. I just need to know you have it. Because if it falls into the wrong hands, its power is immeasurable.
Help me push this out of the way.
Future. Our entire lives depend on it. All be for nothing. You
Jack.
Don't find me.
Your brother addressed that video to me, but I've never met him before in my life.
Well, it sounded like he thought you had his countermeasure.
I wish, but he said it was stolen on July 4th, 2010. Somebody took it. But I'm hoping this place will help us figure out who. I'll give you the honor of pressing the button.
Hey.
Is that?
Yeah, I think so. The second time machine. This changes everything. If we can get this thing working, then we don't need that countermeasure. We can change everything. What if we stop the fracture from ever happening in the first place? We can go back to yesterday, undo everything in the past before it happens. Nobody dies. Paul doesn't go through the machine. Monarch never exists. I mean, it says the time machine core needs to be reset.
Great. What the hell's it look like?
A round thing in the middle. Think. Hey, it looks like I can reset the core from here.
You sure you know what you're doing there?
No clue. But I did help Paul set up the machine at the university.
Which then caused the fracture.
Look, Will knew the calculations were wrong. I'm hoping that means he knew what he was doing here. This is what Will was leading us to. We have to test it. The core. That's what we set up first.
This could actually be the key to finding the countermeasure.
We'll see. It's still resetting. The core is reset. We need to activate it from the control booth.
The controls are up here, according to the monitor.
Here goes nothing.
What was that?
It's fine.
It worked.
It actually worked. Okay. We activate the corridor next.
Okay, there's no way that thing should be exposed like that.
I can't insert the date yet.
You're looking for.
key activated.
Will's key.
Thank God.
Is that supposed to do that?
Will's key did that?
Yeah.
Key to a time machine, and he left it in a trunk of his goddamn car.
That's my brother in a nutshell.
That didn't sound good.
Fuck. Let's just hope it still works.
Something's wrong with the machine.
We don't know that.
You're not trained for this. Anything you do is gonna make it worse. You know I'm right.
Stop trying.
You lost people. You're angry. I get it. But this is bigger than us. We can't fix the machine. But I might know somebody who can. Sophia Amaral.
The Monarch scientist. I saw her video near Ground Zero.
Serene's had a crone in research. She'll be at the Monarch Gala tonight, but security's airtight. She'll be nearly impossible to get to.
Unless I have an invite. Paul told me he expected me to meet him at that party.
Something tells me that was not a friendly invitation. Jack, no.
The future used to be so clear when I was reliving the past. Once I caught up to the moment I had left, that ended. All I've had to go on since then are the plan and the visions. I knew Jack would come to me. I'd seen that. But I didn't know why exactly or how it would end.
There he is. You were right.
My visions of the future aren't always clear, but they don't lie.
Speaking of lies, Joyce is saying he's discovered his brother's time machine.
We've spent 17 years looking for it, and he finds it in less than a day?
Does sound unlikely.
Still, we know it's out there somewhere, and we don't know what his brother managed to tell him.
If he really has located the machine, why would he come here and tell you? Smart Money says he's trying to play you.
Maybe, but the machine is out there. It's in our interest to find out where. And if Jack knows, I have to talk to him.
Dr. Joyce could have provided the answer to that question.
William's attitude and knowledge made him a liability.
Is that angry young man going to cooperate any more than his brother did? You remember Jack as a close friend, but that clouds your judgment. Don't make this personal.
It's not.
But don't forget why we're here tonight. After what happened, our people need reassurance that we're in control. You're the man who can win them over. Let me handle Joyce, so you can concentrate on your speech.
I know what's at stake here, Martin.
Don't even twitch.
And here you are.
I had to see the lifestyles of the sick and traitorous up close and personal. And it was such a nice invitation.
How do you want to deal with this, Paul?
I could still try to reach Jack and make him see reason. Or I could let Hatch deal with him so nothing would distract me from leading Monarch.
Up into the past. Try to change things.
Answer me this question, Bob.
I once trusted Jack more than anybody. It was my only chance to make him understand the truth.
The fuck do you mean nobody got a look at the shooter?
But without me there to give the speech, my empire would start to crumble like a house of cards.
I believe that with hope comes miscalculation, and as you and I are aware, Mr. George, with miscalculation can often come a catastrophe. And that leaves me with you, Mr. Joyce.
But my old friend would be a lost cause, dead and buried along with the rest of my past.
Tonight is a celebration in the face of darkness. Tonight we celebrate because I promise to you that we are prepared.
Monarch would grow stronger with my presence. The plan would go forward as intended. Martin, I'm afraid you're gonna have to cover for me at the speech tonight.
All right.
Jack and I have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah.
Leads. I've been to the end of time, and I've escaped it all the way to 1999, when it all started. I've tried to change things, but by trying, I only made them happen in the first place.
Save us, at least some of us.
You've been the face of Monarch for all these years, Martin. But let's get clear on something. This is still my ship.
You're not thinking clearly. You need your treatment.
You gonna go?
Me? Go to a party.
We can roll together if you want.
What do you want?
I want a statement.
Our group took things too far. Things got very violent. And that violence was because of Jack Joyce.
We just lost communication with Jack Joyce's transport. Find him.
Step away! Right now!
Liam, this isn't what it looks like. No. No! He's gone!
We need all points converged on Liam Burke. He's armed and dangerous.